were back to the grind, or rather in the middle of grinding news from all over the South. The temperature is on a high and so are the stakes, with elections slowly getting under our skin in Karnataka, with all the niceness around us to Andhra still fighting justified fight of special status. Let's get grinding. Met department says that the temperature in Andhra and Telangana could go up to 48 degrees Celsius this summer. 48 degrees Celsius. Man, can you imagine? The advantage is you can play KBC from anywhere because wherever you sit, it will be your hot seat. A few Bengaluru rooftop pubs could lose their license for allegedly violating fire safety norms. Completely false. Those pubs are there to extinguish fire, internal ones. Will everything with Karnataka Congress be nice from now on? Why do I say that? Well, Ashok Kenny, MD of NICE, joined Congress. Hey! After Pinarayi Vijayan became ready for talks, nurses in Kerala put their strike on hold. He probably realized the importance of nurses after he got admitted to the hospital recently. Upendra quit KPJP. The breakup was quite messy. He now plans to launch a new outfit. Very much like his films, his political career is also quite difficult to understand. Budhivantareka matra. A Congress minister called for a ban on cow slaughter. Yeah, Congress, not BJP. So what do we learn from this? It's simple. We are just 2 months away from elections. Kerala High Court ordered CBI probe in Shoaib's murder case. It also criticized police for their shoddy investigation. If my memory serves me right, Pinarayi Vijayan felt exactly the opposite a few days ago. Periyar statue was vandalized in Vellore. You know what? I have a solution to stop all the statue vandalism happening in this country. Just go to the miscreants and say, "Statue!" Well, you're not a miscreant, so you can move. But hey, if this whole saga around the statue has got you still confused, think again after hearing this guy out. We have a dear friend doctor here who has a very different view on the statue vandalism happening in our country. Sir, please enlighten us.
Sister has asked a very good question.
Can you cut those regular lines you use to cover up the thinking that you do to come up with a reply?
Sister already knows my secret.
The entire world knows. Now come to the point.
Coming straight to the point, statues should not be constructed. It leads to sin.
What? You mean constructing statue is a sin?
You're also misquoting me like many others. Constructing statue in itself is not sin, but what it leads to mostly is.
As in?
Statues will make hero out of a normal human being. It will make a person larger than life, which in turn leads to hero worshipping. Idol worshipping, idol worship, as you know, is prohibited. In Yajurveda, chapter number 32, verse number 3, line number 1, it says, "Na tasya pratima asti," which means...
It means nothing in this context.
Sister, you should also understand that structures get built, get demolished, and new structures get built. Like you have life cycle, there is structure cycle. In this case, statue cycle.
What?
In Afghanistan, a few statues were destroyed. The wall in Germany was also destroyed. Are we complaining today? Likewise, a few years later, it won't matter.
Right.
There are many structures partially destroyed in India. Today they are known as World Heritage Sites. Heritage sites.
So?
Moral of the story is, ideologies don't lie in the statues. Whether statues remain or not, ideologies will. And few incidents like these should not get the entire country worked up. I hope I've answered your question, sister.
Are you justifying the act?
Again, you are misunderstanding me. Sister, you must understand.
I understand that I should cut you off now. Look at where humans have brought themselves down to. We're getting riled up about something as unreal and materialistic like statues. Definitely going to see those Achhe Din soon, I guess. Anyway, it's party time, and before you get your shoes on to shake a leg, let me explain. Sandalwood star Upendra is now all set to get his new political party in shape after making his hero-like exit from KPJP, of course. Take a look.
In the garden city of the country, there was a Chanakya, who wasn't a great looker, but was well versed in Vedas and politics. The king, however, was displeased with him. Chanakya was to be caged, but he slid out in disguise.
We can now safely say that Upendra is a party animal, no? But hey, while he's brewing up his ingredients to make his party, what do? Mind your own business and go have a party of your own. Goodbye.